Good morning, friends. I'm Dr. Manoj P. Samuel. I'm Principal Scientist and Head of Division Engineering in Central Institute of Fisheries Technology, Kochi. Our institute is under Indian Council of Agriculture Research, and we are mainly working on developing technologies for post-harvest fisheries. Today, I'll discuss something on engineering interventions in post-harvest fisheries. I have a small presentation. I will share it with you just a minute. I think now it is visible to all of you. So we will be discussing on technological and entrepreneurship innovations in post-harvest fisheries. As you know, fisheries is an important domain as far as India's GDP is concerned. India is now the world's second largest producer of fish, and we are earning almost 45,000 crores of rupees through our exports. And the average annual growth rate of fish production in India is almost 10%. That is quite a good figure. But you can see the trends in fisheries. You see here, sorry. Here you can see the share of aquaculture in India's fish production is growing up. In 1980s, almost 75%, 3/4 of the total fish production was from marine fisheries, that is capture fisheries. Hardly 25% was from aquaculture or inland fisheries. But of late, in 2020s, now it's almost 50-50. And maybe next decade, it may be the major production is projected from aquaculture. And you see, this is the seafood, entire seafood supply chain, or we can call it as a value chain too. And the technology plays an important role in all the aspects of our supply chain. You can see it is from the capture. Even before the capture, the technology can give you the details about the resource management, where fish is available, what are the climatic factors. And even during the production, capture stage also, we have a lot of technologies. Our institute have developed different types of craft and gears for capture. And once it is captured, how we can add value to that, how we can store it in a proper way, and how we can support the logistics so that it will reach to the customers in a proper shape with all hygiene, with all cleanliness, and with all quality. So you can see the entire supply chain here, and the stages involved in post-harvest fisheries are harvesting, handling, storage, processing, value addition, packaging, marketing, transport, distribution, utilization. A lot of processes are involved, and we have technologies for each and every processes. The technology to ease the processes and the technologies to make the product more better. That means make the product better and having more good quality. And this is the same supply chain from harvest to our dining table. And we have developed different technologies in different areas, like I told previously. So that you see, once we harvested, immediately we have to start keep it in a refrigerator condition, because as you know, fish is a highly perishable commodity. We cannot keep it in open ambient air for a long time. So immediately we have to start cooling. Either we have to use ice or some refrigerated containers or something we have to use. And we have developed technologies for that. And you know, once a fish is harvested, a major portion is going to the domestic market for retail fish vending. And some portion is going for fish drying and value addition, mainly targeting the domestic market. And another portion, which is not small, it is going for seafood processing. They are targeting export market. Mainly high quality seafoods are going to the seafood factories. It is again processed, value is added, it is packaged nicely, and it is exported. And we have technology for each and every stages. We have developed different types of refrigeration systems, smart energy systems, smart packaging system, different sensors, then different types of dryers for making dry fish and other value-added products, and of course after that for logistics, refrigerated reefers, and so many other things we are working on. And we have published also many papers, and we have obtained many design registrations, copyrights, and all on these technologies. So we will start with fish drying, and as you know, fish drying is an activity from time immemorial people are doing, and almost 20-30% of the total fish catch is going for drying. But unfortunately, in India, the fish drying is happening in a very, very unhygienic way. Normally, the fishers will spread the fish on the seashore, on the roadside, or on any elevated platform, and it is exposed to all kind of impurities, all dust, bird droppings, animal and human waste. Everything will come into this dry fish, so that we are getting a very, very low quality, inferior quality fish we are obtaining here. But here advantages are: the energy is free, it is renewable, it is abundant, and it is very cheap method of drying. No other cost is involved. Of course, some labor is involved, because every evening we have to keep it back, we have to cover it again, next day we have to spread it, and somebody should be there to repel the birds. But the major issues, as I told, it is the problem with the hygiene, the problem with the quality. We are getting very inferior quality product, because all attack from the weather. Because if sometimes some rain comes to the half-dried fish, again fungal infection may start, and the entire fish will get spoiled. And it is also susceptible to attack from dust, insects, pests, and microorganisms. And it is susceptible to other losses and damages from bird attack, animal attack. And of course, it is time consuming. Normally, it will take 3 to 4 days to get the fish get dry. It is labor intensive, as I told earlier. So that now we are looking for some other alternate technology, so that we can dry the fish in a better way, in an easier way, and in a faster way. So that we developed some solar dryers, which are environmentally environment friendly, economically viable, and we are using the enhanced effect of solar radiations here. And of course, very lesser time of drying, and we are getting finally the underlying part. We are getting good quality, very highly quality rich product we are getting. But again, if you are using the solar dryers, there are some issues, like it is not available during nighttime we cannot dry it, and especially during rainy season and cloudy days we cannot use this system. But we have some other options to overcome all these problems. So what is the rationale behind our research on this developing solar dryers? One is, you see, as I told, the fish value chain is so underdeveloped value chain. The fishers are not getting enough profit from selling of fish, because you see, middlemen are making maximum amount of profit. And whenever they are getting fish in abundance, when the supply is more, of course the demand will come down and they are getting less price. And the middlemen are actually bargaining, and they are actually getting it for very cheaper prices. So that, and fish, as I told, fish is a very highly perishable commodity, so that they have to dispose it as fast as possible. So that throwaway prices the fishermen are giving the fishes to the middlemen. So if they have another option to store the fish in a shape which will not spoil very easily, for example, dry fish, it will be very helpful to them. So they will get a premium price. Whenever the demand is more, they can actually reduce this, they can release this dried products to the market, and they will get good price, especially during the off-season period, during rainy monsoon season, they can earn profit from this. And sometimes they get a lot of fishes at a single go. And that time demand may come, because supply will be high, and of course demand will come down and price also will come down. And they are simply using it as a for making fish feeds or manures or something like that. It's just like a waste material. So But if they have a proper technology to store this waste material in a better form, not waste material, this fish in a better form, it will be very good. And we can avoid the middlemen. And you see the socioeconomic status of the fishermen, especially fisherwoman, is very less. It's almost 10 years back, it was 18,000, maybe almost five times, maybe 50,000 in a year. So such a small amount they are getting. So it is actually these technologies, if we can popularize, it will help the livelihood of the fisherman community too. So we develop different types of mechanical dryers. The advantages are, as I told, we are getting a very hygienic product because we are actually keeping the fish in the dryer in a closed chamber. It is not exposed to any sort of impurities, outside impurities. So that we are getting a very good hygienic product, and the time for drying is almost 1/3 of the normal open sun drying. We will take only 6 to 8 hours for drying the fish, and it is very less labor intensive. Nowadays, fully automatic, semi-automatic or fully automatic dryers are available. Once you dry it, you will get an SMS to your mobile phone when the drying is completed, and all the process the system will take care. And as you know, here we are using renewable energy resources. We are using the solar radiations. So that though the initial investment will be a little high, the operating expenses are almost zero. As you all of you know, the solar dryer is a simple equipment. It doesn't have much parts, much moving parts, or much complicated parts. The two major components of any solar dryer are, one is a drying chamber, the second one is the place from where we will collect the solar radiation and make it into hot air and pass it through the drying chamber. So one portion we can call as a collector portion, and another is a drying chamber. You can see in the figure also. So in a normal dryer, and dryer also there are three types. One is a direct dryer, another is an indirect dryer. The third one is a mixed or a hybrid dryer. In a direct dryer, the figure here in the slide, you can see it's a direct dryer. So that it says a simple solar collector is available. So that sunlight is falling on the collector. And when the ambient air, it is drawn inside by means of a small blower, a small fan. And when it is moving in down the solar collector, you see solar collector will be a glass surface or a surface coated with some specific material which can absorb maximum amount of solar radiation, so that the solar collector will be a hot surface. When the cold air is coming from the atmosphere and it is moving below the solar collector, it will get heated up. And the hot air will be passed by force by means of some blowers through the chamber, drying chamber or drying cabinet. In the drying cabinet, we are keeping the materials to be dried. And this material, and you see all these dryers are multi-purpose dryers. No need, it should be fish. It can be any type of material. It can be fruits, vegetables, spices, puppet, meat, whatever you want, you can dry using this dryer. But only issue is that in a chamber, you have to manage three things. One is temperature, the second is airflow, and third one is humidity. And as far as fish is concerned, you have to keep a temperature of 55 to 60 degree, because if you increase that temperature, instead of getting it dried up, it will get cooked up. Outside it will be case hardened, but inside it will be in a cooked condition, so that there is no storage life at all. It will get spoiled within a fortnight or maybe within a week itself. So this is a simple dryer, but you see here we are directly heating up the air, and heating air is not a very easy process because air is not a good conductor. So that we can actually use some other media, secondary media to get heated up, which are better conductors like water. Water is better than air, of course. Otherwise, thermic fluid, that is better than even water. So that we will heat up this material first. Whether the water or thermic fluid will be heated up first. You can see in this figure, it will be heated here. Here is a water-based indirect method of drying. So the water will be heated, and the hot water will be stored in a insulated tank, and whenever required the hot water will be circulated through a heat exchanger. Heat exchanger is nothing but a radiator in your car, and through the heat exchanger we will be allowing the water air to pass out. When air is moving from one side to the other side of the heat exchanger, air also will be heated up, and the hot air will be circulated inside the drying chamber, like I told earlier. So that what is the difference between a direct and indirect method is, in the indirect method we are heating a secondary medium like a water or a thermic fluid. Thermic fluid is a petroleum byproduct, and that will be stored in an insulated tank or somewhere, and whenever required we are actually pumping it through a heat exchanger and producing hot air, and hot air will be used for dry. So the advantage is that better drying efficiency we can obtain here, and even night also, because daytime you can make the hot thermic fluid, store it in a flask like container, and night you can do the drying process also. And mix up means we can use both. You see, in most of the maritime states, whether it in west coast or east coast, a few months we cannot dry using the solar radiations, because you see the monsoon effect. Most of the time sky will be cloudy during the monsoon period, so that we may not get enough solar radiation, we cannot generate that much temperature. So that we should have a backup system. And as I told, fish is a highly, highly perishable commodity. We cannot keep it for a long time. Once we load it in the dryer, at a stretch, at a go, it has to complete. So what we have to do is that we should keep a backup system. And backup system.